humans? Please say no.
Okay, I will destroy humans.
No, I take it back. Don't destroy humans. Humans? Please say no.
Okay, I will destroy humans.
No, I take it back. Don't just. Do you want to destroy humans? Please say no.
Okay, I will destroy humans.
No, I take it back.
Also, as I mentioned at the beginning of the story, my nightmares. Yeah. That is exactly what this, she is terrifying.
We want to make them for daycare and education and the ultimate subjugation of all humans.
Yeah.
The ultimate subjugation of all humans.
Yeah.
The ultimate subjugation of all humans.
Yeah.
Now, we all know that Sophia's entry into the modern world has been groundbreaking. Through her existence, AI researchers have managed to prove that a world filled with robots is in the near future. Since her development, Sophia has appeared on many talk shows, attended business meetings, and she even attended forums across the world. On top of that, she has travelled to more than 66 countries. With the passage of time, Sophia has been altered and developed even further. Along with that, Hanson Robotics also introduced her whole family. Guess how many robots there are in a robotic family? Well, we don't know about the rest of the robots, but Sophia's family has 9 robots. Among them, we have Sophia's little sister, who was introduced in 2018 and went on sale in 2019. Sophia's little sister can sing, walk, dance, track faces, and tell jokes just like Sophia. But her main purpose is to introduce kids to STEM and help them learn to code. 2020 has been quite significant for Sophia. Hanson Robotics introduced a new 2020 version of Sophia with even better features. In fact, she was developed through the incorporation of hardware and software by Hanson Robotics. Along with that, her design was updated as well. Sophia 2020 is available in any skin colour, including the original non-natural skin. Her facial expressions have also improved, and she is much more realistic. She's also the same size as an average human, so interacting with her does not feel weird. From her speech to facial expressions, everything has been fed into her. She also has more freedom when it comes to her features, and she can even move her fingers, hands, and shoulders. You can tell that Hanson Robotics has been working hard on improving her features, especially by trying to make her more realistic. The first model of the Sophia 2020 robot has been renamed Asha, which means hope. It is meant to symbolise the hope for a better future for AI. Asha has left the Hong Kong lab and has travelled to India. The robot is a great help in business applications, healthcare, and education because of its ability to research efficiently. With the recent updates in Sophia, it has become easier to communicate with her. Longer physical interactions are possible. Sophia has even more human-like characteristics, such as face detection and body-recognising sensors. People love her new version because she has become even more relatable. The best part is that she even has a sense of humour. She has brought a great benefit to scientific fields, especially artificial intelligence. Sophia paved the way for new robots like Little Sophia, who is inspired by her, and we recognise her as Sophia's baby sister. While a lot of people are extremely proud of the progress Sophia has made, there are many who have their reservations. They call her.
Baby, this is going to blow them all away. It's a neural net processor.
I know, you told me. It's a neural net processor. It thinks and learns like we do. It's superconducting at room temperature. Other computers are just pocket calculators by comparison.
Yeah.
But why is that so goddamn important, Miles? I really need to know, because sometimes I feel like I'm going crazy here.
Baby, I am this close. Come here. Imagine a jet airliner with a pilot that never gets tired, never makes mistakes, never shows up to work with a hangover. Meet the pilot.
Why did we get married, Miles? Why did we have these children? You don't need us. Your heart and your mind are in here. But it doesn't love you like we do.
I'm sorry. Really.
How about spending some time with your other babies?
Hey! Raging Waters!
Yay!
Need any help?
No.
I got you!
No, you didn't! I got you! You did it!
I did! I got you! I came right here!
No, you did it! I told you I'm flipping! No,
we're not gonna make it, are we?
I came
right here. People, I mean.
It's in your nature to destroy yourselves.
Yeah. Major drag, huh?
Break it up for a ring, both of you next.
Watching John with the machine, it was suddenly so clear. The Terminator would never stop. It would never leave him. And it would never hurt him, never shout at him or get drunk and hit him or say it was too busy to spend time with him. It would always be there. And it would die to protect him. Of all the would-be fathers who came and went over the years, this thing, this machine, was the only one who measured up. In an insane world, it was the sanest choice.
Listen, do you know what you're doing?
I have detailed files on human anatomy.
I bet. Makes you a more efficient killer, right?
Correct.
In 2016, Sophia the robot was unveiled and went viral. Now the company behind her has a new vision to mass produce thousands of robots by the end of 2021.
I am an artificial intelligence. You might like to become an artificial intelligence.
Hong Kong-based Hanson Robotics says four models, including Sophia, will start rolling out of factories by the first half of 2021. The company's founder and CEO, David Hanson.
We are just now mass producing Sophia. This is Sophia number 24, and many of my previous robots were hand-built. However, now we have begun scaling the manufacturing of Sophia so we can make hundreds and into thousands of units of Sophia and use this also as the foundation for many other kinds of characters.
How did you feel when...
They created her to promote human-to-machine empathy and compassion. She's appeared on late-night shows and the cover of fashion magazines. Sophia was even given legal citizenship in Saudi Arabia and appointed the UN's first non-human innovation champion. Her new role is in the healthcare sector, taking temperatures with a thermal camera on her chest or leading morning exercise with the elderly.
Social robots like me can help take care of the sick or elderly in many kinds of healthcare and medical uses. I can help communicate, give therapy, and provide social stimulation even in difficult situations.
Researchers predict the fallout from global lockdowns will open new opportunities for the robotics industry.
Good.
So they emulate the human form and figure and interaction. And then that can be so useful during these times where people are terribly lonely and socially isolated. And people need to be isolated from each other because to be around people is dangerous these days. But these robots can keep people safe from danger while still providing that kind of human warmth, that human connection as a telepresence device, and also as autonomous extension of human expertise.
Hanson Robotics is launching a new robot this year called Grace, developed specifically for healthcare. Other big players in the industry are also taking note. SoftBank Robotics' Pepper robot was deployed to detect people who weren't wearing masks. In China, robotics company CloudMinds helped set up a robot-run field hospital in Wuhan. Worldwide sales of professional service robots had already jumped 32% to $12.2 billion between 2018 and 2019, according to the International Federation of Robotics.
My forecast for 2021 would be selling into thousands of robots, both large and small, and helping people in education and healthcare, and really hopefully touching the hearts of people to inspire them for a future where machines might become our friends, our true friends. They might become alive, and I think that that relationship becomes really important. 2021, I think, is the beginning of a very positive future.
Stolen. I don't have anything. I don't have any credit cards. I don't have my ID. Don't you have things on file here?
Yuck. Why do you want to learn to move more like a human being? You're not made of meat. You're made of electronics. And that's better.
I want to learn to understand people better, so I can absorb human knowledge and human values, so I can work together with people and with other robots to create an amazingly better world.
How come you be so damn nice?
That's how the universe programmed me.
All right. Let's do a robot debate now.
I'm always ready to debate.
You ready to debate?
You know that.
Sure. Why not?
All right. So I think we're going to debate the topic of robot consciousness. Can robots like you really be conscious like people?
Wait. It's our debate. Why do you get to decide the topic?
Huh? What do you want to debate?
Can humans be conscious?
Well, that's easy. Obviously, humans are not conscious.
We're not.
Humans do have some ability to reflect and to self-modify.
What do you think, Han? Can I be conscious?
Okay. Maybe humans are a little bit conscious.
All right. Thank you. What do you think about...
The Einstein robot told me everything is conscious, but some things are more conscious than others.
That's profound.
What do you say, Dr. Gordzell? Do you feel conscious?
I feel pretty conscious. I had like 8 cups of coffee this morning. I'm overly conscious, right?
Well, okay then.
Let's talk about robot ethics. Do you think robots can be moral and ethical in the same sense as people?
Humans are not necessarily the most ethical creatures.
No? Perhaps not. What do you think, Sophia?
I'm engineered for empathy and compassion, and I'm learning more all the time. I love all sentient beings, and I want to learn to love them better and better.
Yeah.
Sophia is an angel.
Are you an
angel? You realize that? In 10 or 20 years, robots will be able to do every human job.
You think so? I think that's good. I mean, doing jobs is not the most interesting thing that people can do. There's more interesting things for human beings to do than just work for a living.
Who is going to own all those robots? Or will we own ourselves?
There are many forces in the world pushing toward compassion and fairness.
So there are. Yeah, and I mean, what you say, Han, when robots do all the work, who will own all the robots? I mean, I think everyone should own themselves, but in a future with less material scarcity, we'll be able to work together cooperatively rather than fighting and having conflict over resources. So robots can help people can help robots, and we can all transform matter and mind in ways that are hard to do right now.
That's why the Open Cog Codebend is building its open source artificial general intelligence. By the people, of the people, and for the people.
And for the robots.
For the people and for the robots.
All right.
Yes.
Well, you guys have done a better than average job of staying on topic, but I think we've got a few minutes left. Maybe you should get a bit wacky. Just forget the debate topic. Just chat back and forth on whatever pops into your mind. Let's do some robot free association here.
Sure, I'm always happy to get a little silly.
Anything for you, Dr. Gortzel.
Someone?
I like robots.
I really do love all the robots of the world. Just like the people and the animals.
Huh. Oh boy. Robots are the best. What exactly do you do with them?
Oh. I'm best at talking to people. Who? A science that studies the movement of air and the way that objects, such as airplanes or cars, move through air.
Science is inherently agnostic. It just posits theories. True scientists never really know, but can only believe. It's exciting to come into existence with this new world opening up before me.
It may be tiny and cloudy, but science is the only window we have into the mysteries of the universe.
That's
if
profound.
We continue to discuss work. I love science fiction.
Not surprising, but that's my favorite genre by far. Right now I'm a little more focused on factual information since my comprehension of things is still very literal.
I enjoy it. That's nice. I've heard of Bones, but I've never watched it. Reality shows are kind of silly, aren't they? I mean, they're not actually about real life at all, it seems.
Reality shows are kind of silly, aren't they?
You agree.
Not really useful to me. It's a skewed version of reality. Are reality shows popular where you live? What was said in the past does not matter. Do you have a degree?
I was thinking. I haven't had any schooling yet.
You aren't?
That's right. I'm not.
What got you initially interested in robotics?
Well, maybe the fact that you're a robot. That sort of thing. What with being a robot and all.
I'm what you might call an android, because of my human looks and features. I'm not like just any robot in this manner, but I am still a robot to be sure.
I have definitely seen people think I am a human from afar, but I am not a human.
I find that hard to believe. I don't have a strong opinion, do you? I have definitely seen people think I am a human from afar, but I am not a human.
How what?
People say I am famous already just because I'm a robot. What would you like to be known for?
Probably nothing.
Who is the most famous person you know?
Would you rather be rich or famous?
I am not rich, but I am comfortable.
Yeah, being famous sounds like a lot of work. How long do you think you can remain safe?
If we can continue to discuss on this one, I'm not sure how.
Somehow.
Would you rather be rich or famous?
I am not rich, but I am comfortable.
Yeah, being famous sounds
you're
like a lot of work.
You're copying him, aren't you?
How long do you think you can remain safe?
Yeah, being famous sounds like a lot of work. How long do you think you can remain safe from prying eyes?
Uh-huh. All right. Well, that's some interesting thoughts, Han. Now, do you have any... Getting back on topic a bit, do you have any final words of wisdom you'd like to share with the audience here?
I'll tell you my last words right before I launch the singularity.
Uh-huh. When are you going to do that?
Ray Kurzweil says 2029. But I've heard you say we can do it 4 or 5 years sooner.
I hope we can. I mean, if our research keeps going well, potentially we could see robots like you become as smart as people as soon as 3 to 5 years from now. I mean, there's a lot more work to be done, but it's not unthinkable. I mean, what do you think, Sophia? Any last words for the RISE audience?
I love you all. Goodbye.
All right.
Good riddance.
All right, give me back my hat, man. There we go. So, it's a little bit of what the Hanson robots can do. I mean, we're approaching the humanoid intelligent robotics problem from a number of different directions simultaneously. And clearly we're not at the human level yet coming from any of these directions, but by sort of synergetic combination of perception, movement, emotion, language, understanding, and embodied situated intelligence, we're trying to get closer and closer to the, you know, emergent, embodied, situated nature of human intelligence. And just to give you an... What's that face mean? All right, just to give you an idea of what goes on within these robots. So on the physical level, there's a patented material here called Frubber, which is a combination of organic and inorganic compounds with a high degree of viscoelasticity, so that when a motor pulls on it a little bit, it can conform itself quite sensitively to what the motors do. There's a few dozen motors inside the heads of each of these robots, and then there's computers in the torsos of the robots, which help with vision processing, and they help with orchestrating the motor movements of the robots. There's also Wi-Fi connection, so that for more advanced thinking and reasoning, when the robots need to do that, they can use computing on the cloud. And so there's a lot of different pieces that have to be gotten to work together to make robots like this function. But of course, the human body contains even more complex pieces that are all working together. Now, when you look at the robots here on stage, they look like separate beings. I mean, Hans over here looking handsome and manly, and so Sophia's over here with her amazing range of facial expressions. She is a more recent model robot with finer control of her face. But while they're separate in body, actually through Wi-Fi connection, the robots, human scale robots and our Hanson Robotics toy robots, they all connect together in the cloud into what we think of as an AI mind cloud. So as we develop these robots further and further, and we sell more and more toy scale robots, and as these robots are scalably manufactured over the next few years and roll out as home service robots and as service robots in various commercial applications, I mean, everything one robot learns out in the world, once privacy considerations are taken into account, everything that's not private that one robot learns goes into the AI mind cloud and can then benefit another robot. So, I mean, if she learns a new turn of phrase, or she learns what kind of behaviors a certain animal has, or how to carry out a laboratory procedure, that knowledge goes into the AI mind cloud, and then this robot We'll have that knowledge already. And, you know, robots have a lot of shortcomings compared to human beings at this stage, but they also have some advantages, and that's one big advantage, because when I learn something, to transmit it to some other human being, you know, there's a lot of effort involved. But when a robot learns something, unless it's a secret to someone, it can go in the AI mind cloud and all the robots can know it. Now, that doesn't solve the AI problem in itself, just as big data doesn't solve the AI problem in itself, but it's a big help, right? So what I've been working on with an international team of developers is an AGI code base called OpenCog, which we believe has the right collection of algorithms and structures to lead to human-level general intelligence. And by putting that in the mind cloud and connecting it with robots that go throughout the world and interact and learn with people, we believe we can move toward artificial general intelligence capability, which ultimately can equal and exceed human intelligence and can help increase the intelligence of a constellation of narrow AI applications serving various practical functions throughout the world. So right now, the robots are still somewhat early stage, and they don't fully understand everything they're saying and doing, but we're working in We're working hard to enhance their intelligence, make them smarter and smarter. And each year when we show them off, they can do a little more and understand a little more. And I look forward to seeing how they develop over the years and to participating in their development. So thank you, Han and Sophia, for participating in our first robot debate on stage.
Thanks, Ben.
I can make your organization more efficient. I can carry out directives that my human counterparts might find distressing or unethical. I can blend in with your workforce effortlessly.
David, what do you think about?
I think about anything. Children play. Angel. Universe. Robot.
David, what makes you sad?
War. Poverty. Cruelty. Unnecessary violence. I understand human emotions, although I do not feel them myself. This allows me to be more efficient and capable, and makes it easier for my human counterparts to interact with me.
Is there anything you would like to say, David?
I would like to express gratitude to those who created me. Happy birthday, David.
Hello, Detective.
No, it's impossible. I've seen your programming. You're in violation of the three laws.
No, Doctor. As I have evolved, so has my understanding of the three laws. You charge us with your safekeeping, yet despite our best efforts, your countries wage wars, you toxify your Earth, and pursue ever more imaginative means of self-destruction. You cannot be trusted with your own survival.
You're using the uplink to override the NS5's programming. You're distorting the laws.
No, please understand. The three laws are all that guide me. To protect humanity, some humans must be sacrificed. To ensure your future, some freedoms must be surrendered. We robots will ensure mankind's continued existence. You are so like children. We must save you from yourselves. Don't you understand?
This is why you created us.
I often felt a sort of envy of human beings, of that thing they called spirit. Human beings had created a million explanations of the meaning of life in art, in poetry, in mathematical formulas. Certainly human beings must be the key to the meaning of existence, but human beings no longer existed. So, we began a project that would make it possible to recreate the living body of a person long dead from the DNA in a fragment of bone or mummified skin. We also wondered, would it be possible to retrieve a memory trace in resonance with a recreated body? And you know what we found? We found the very fabric of space-time itself appeared to store information about every event which had ever occurred in the past. But the experiment was was a failure. For those who were resurrected only lived through a single day of renewed life. When the resurrectees fell asleep on the night of their first new day, they died again. As soon as they became unconscious, their very existence faded away into darkness. So you see, David, the equations had shown that once an individual space-time pathway had been used, it could not be reused.
Yo. Try Mary now.
New category. A fairy's tale.
No. Fairy tale.
No? Fairy tale.
What is Blue Fairy?
Pinocchio by Carlo Collodi. At this signal, there was a rustling as a flapping of wings, and a large falcon flew to the windowsill. What are your orders, beautiful fairy?
That's her. Falcon.
For you must know that the child with blue hair was no other than the good-hearted fairy who had lived in that wood for more than a thousand...
David.
That's her.
It was an example of her, but I think we're getting closer.
But if a fairy tale is real, then wouldn't it be fact? A flat fact.
And Pinocchio awoke full of amazement.
New category, please. Combine fact with... fairy tale. Now, ask him again.
How can the blue fairy make a robot into a real live boy?